Hey everybody, welcome to episode 28, I think, of Let's Build Minecraft. I've done some work. I've done quite a bit of work, actually. I've done some work here. You can see last episode we were working on this house and a little secret inside of it. And then we had the wheat field come up to this pond and we built this wall. Well, I'm still working on bringing the wheat field up to what is going to be the pathway here. This isn't quite done yet. And then I'm going to have to figure out some sort of way to something's got to go between the road and the wheat field. If it's just right next to some fence, something, some walls, I don't know. We had a suggestion by Buzz Minecraft. Go check him out. He makes his own videos. To add some barrels down here. So I added two barrels. I've used these before. It's just a log and a trapdoor on top of it. And then this with an actual lapis block covered by trapdoors. You know, it kind of looks like he's got a barrel there full of lapis. Close that back up. Kind of looks like it's boarded up, right? So what have we done today? I need to eat. Look what a beautiful day it is. It is a beautiful day, just like it is here in real life. It's pretty nice. Actually, it's kind of warm. I don't know why I'm saying that. It's actually kind of warm. So right here, you can see one thing, but that's not the first thing I want to talk about. The first thing I want to talk about is mossy stone bricks. So what was it? 1.9, they added a crafting recipe for mossy stone bricks, which is just vines with stone bricks, like one and one in the crafting table or right here. It's a different color of green. It drives me nuts. And you can tell, like, from a distance. Maybe not, but I can tell. It's like a little bluish. I don't know if they don't change for biomes. I guess I could check by putting one in a river biome. Let's check. Right now, right here, we're in plains, right? Yeah, plains, beach. Is that looking different? I don't think that's any different. And then river. Why does the top look so much brighter than the sides? The sides looks grungy. I guess that's kind of for building, using it for grungy walls. And then this is for grassy walkways, I guess. But it doesn't seem that it changes with the biomes, which may be causing a problem. So I don't know. I may keep it. I may not. Another thing I did, I ate a potato and I built this. Now this is a layout for another house, because if we come back here, you can see we've got a number of houses here and they all face the same freaking direction. We need to add a house right here, and that's going to be another off-camera thing, I think, adding these houses. Nothing special. A lot of them are very similar, so I do them off camera. But this one's going to be facing the other way, so it's got a roof going the opposite direction of these. So it can just stick out a little bit and break up the monotony that I didn't realize that I had going. Now this, same idea that I've been going with. A cobblestone bottom half that's set in one compared to the top. But then I brought it out for this little workshop here. There's no interior yet. And I placed those dirt so I can place the hay on top. And I don't have enough hay to finish up that messy hay look. I did spend about half an hour collecting this entire field. And it gives you about a stack and a half of hay blocks, which It's about a stack and a half. I go through quite a bit of it. It's kind of a pain in the butt. I should have just taken, the few hours that I've spent mining hay for this whole town and made a dang wheat farm and made it easier on myself. But yeah, right here, I really like this. It's blocked in by walls. We got a cauldron here. I don't know what this is. I put coal under it and like a grate. I don't know, like a grill or something. I don't know. These aren't usable, but they're there for looks. And then we've got this, which does lead up to a chimney up there. So it's a different house. I think it does stick out nicely. And I think it's a nice thing to look at coming into the town. Now, I want to go into creative, and you can see that I've gone into creative and changed my times there. I'm not a cheater. Sometimes I'll change my time if I'm just trying to get around and fly and look at stuff to make plans, which is exactly what I'm doing right here. So I was trying to figure out, what do I want? What do I expect from the rest of this town? Because looking up here, I realized this town is fairly close to being done. It's not there yet. We still got a bit of work, but it's getting there. We've got a good wheat field, and this wheat field's still going to need to be expanded, but, that's off-camera work. I want the town itself to be bigger, but, spend a half an hour on a town or on a house, take 2 or 3 hours on a weekend or something and build a bunch over here. This town's going to grow. That's more off-camera work. I don't really have much plans for over here, maybe a few houses. Over here, we already know that this is going to be some sort of port for boats and whatnot. And over here, this is what we're going to be messing with today, which, if you've seen the title of the video, you probably already know what it's going to be. So I was thinking, what do we want from this town? And so it's a farming town, and I was thinking, well, one thing I'd like to do is maybe some sort of archery range, because I grew up with a lot of farmers, I know a lot of farmers, and they almost all hunt. So some sort of hunting practice would be fitting, I think. I really like that house in the distance. I want to keep that isolated. So maybe something like that, that's a one episode project. I want to do some sort of manor or town hall deal. Nothing too fancy. This town won't have anything fancy, just looking at it. It's a small farming town. But I want something. Let's actually go into survival. Oh, that's not survival. And go to sleep. Do I have a bed in here? No, I don't. And it's not even lit up. Shame on me. I gotta do interiors. That might be another episode, or maybe it'll be off-camera work. I don't know. Are people interested in watching a full episode dedicated to interiors? For me, I'd probably get a little bored watching that. I don't know about everyone else, though. Buildings like this need to get finished. That port's going to be a few episodes worth of work. That manor, the town expanding, and then the manor will take up a good bit of the rest of the area over here. And maybe we could even put something over there. Now, I don't want to reach into the mountains here. If we go up here, it's just a lot of gravel. It is pretty flat right up here, but it is extreme hills. And I don't want to reach back into the forest. We've got our campsite back there, not too far away. So this town is actually... I need these bones. I have a zombie experience farm, and I wish so badly that it was a skeleton farm because of the new bone blocks, but we're going to have to find one or something. Yeah, this place is actually coming along pretty well. A lot of off-camera work left to do. That's not going to work for what we're doing. And you guys should know what we're doing. Like I said, it's in the title. I'll get to that in a little bit. So yeah, we got to start thinking about the next town, and I'm thinking that the next town that I want to do is going to be a big city. Big city with a big castle. And it might be something that we start on and then go to another town to work on, or go back to our old town that we've worked on that we haven't been to for a while. And something's got to happen there. It's a little boring there. I've got to come up with some new ideas, but I'm going to get some materials ready. We're going to build a cow pasture, and it's not going to be just a regular cow pasture. It's going to be, I want to make it interesting. It's not going to just be fence. I want it to be interesting, so we're going to get right into that. All right, this is a cow pasture. You're going to have to relocate here. I don't care if you go up there with that guy. I don't care if you go over there with those guys. But you can't be here. Go away. Okay, so I flattened this out a little bit off camera. I had already done that and removed all the grass and whatnot. Sunflowers were rampant over here. And I redid this face, this wall. Tried to make it look like a cliff with a wall incorporated into it. Over here, the river hadn't gone through all the way. I made it go through. Same thing there. I think it looks all right. I could maybe touch up the smooth stone and the dirt. But right now, our focus is going to be making a cow pasture with walls that combine stone sections, like man-made stone, cobblestone, and whatnot sections. Can they get through that? When you use blocks, you gotta make sure that they can't get through any of this. So the backside here, where this cliff is primarily stone and cobblestone. I've got that figured out, and then I've got a lot of fence here, and then what we're going to do is place down the fence with spaces at random intervals, and then put stuff like this around it. Now, there was a spot over here that could get through. I don't think they can get through here. I don't know if a baby cow can get through here or not. Pretty sure an adult can't, and I'm pretty sure that they aren't tricky enough to do that. If they are, then they've earned their freedom. They can be gone. We're not going to fill this pasture up to the brim. I want it to be like realistic livestock, realistic condition. I told you you can't be here, though. I'll kill you. If you think I won't eat horse meat, shoot. All right. So this stuff, let's just string it along. Actually, let's incorporate it into the wall like that so it mixes a little bit. Ooh, I think that's a good idea. Maybe even a little bit like that. No, I'm not huge on that. It doesn't need to be there. And in fact, if we did that, then they'd be able to get out. So that's not gonna work. In fact, they could get out like that too. So much for that idea. But let's do it like this. And then we can have those gaps. It's pasture, I guess. We probably shouldn't have gaps just for the sake of, you know, having that realistic touch. So let's have a gap there. And then just kind of spam this. I'll come back and fill these in. Now, how big do we want it to be? I want it to come down here a little bit. I definitely don't want to take up too much room, because a lot of this is going to be city room. Let's go something like this, right? And then I'll touch this up on my own, make it not look like I just randomly placed it. But I kind of want a little bit of that random touch as well, that organic feeling. See if I can do this without needing more fence. I don't think I'm going to be able to. Well, That's a real organic shape right there. Yep. Gonna need you to not be there. Let's do something like that, and then this is a pretty good size. So let's start off with that and touch up the fence, and I'll be back. This is the kind of thing I'm talking about. Randomly spaced, kind of looks like maybe we were in a field that had rocks, had stones, and they incorporated them into the fence. Maybe we could add some over here. I'm sure the cows would love to climb on them and play on them. The only bad thing is we can eliminate gaps that way, but there's going to be a gap this way. Nothing. Okay, this isn't good. A few days ago, I started having problems with Java SE binary, I think, crashing while I'm playing. Well, I had updated my Java, and it seemed to fix the problem. I've been playing here for 2 or 3 hours, but that is the second time that it crashed in about 4 minutes. I hope I can finish recording an episode today, because I looked online and could not find a reliable answer to a solution on it. And it sounded like people were playing this game and it had gotten to the point where, like, they couldn't play the game. And obviously, I don't want that happening. Can they get up? They could probably jump over there, couldn't they? Okay, that looks ugly, but I gotta keep them from being able to do some, the telephone, doing something of that variety. The first time it crashed was when I tried exiting this world, which I had done before. But that time just stopped while I was playing. But anyways, I guess let's just try to play. Getting nervous. Okay, so we've got a big section here. So let's do something like this. Actually, something like this. And then that's got to go up one, or else they're just going to be able to climb over it. And they could probably jump up like that. I don't think that they're going to. Maybe we just do something like that. Well, this way they're definitely going to be able to. You know, it kind of looks like a mess. It's not supposed to look pretty. So I'm going to do that for the rest of these. First thing that I want to do, though, before I get on that, is the entrance. Let's put it right here, and then I've done this in a few other places. When I go around gates, I will stop bothering me. Phone. I don't know. I don't even know if you can hear that. You can probably hear it. Do something like this, and then have them at different heights. Just makes them look, I don't know what it makes it look like. We could even, that's what I've done over there a few times, but what if we did it like that? I'm not a huge fan of that. Maybe if we put slabs over it? Do we have slabs? We don't have wood slabs. Let me try that. That looks like something. It's not something that I like, I don't think. There's probably a way to get it to work like that, but it's not really the look I'm going for, so I'm going to grab those back. Gimme, and I'm going to finish up the rest of these, and hopefully without a crash. I believe that we are being held in. I did a few little jobs like this where I just put walls, and then I put stone on the back side of the walls, so we weren't actually using walls or using stone as part of the walls and having to worry about if they could climb over it or not, like here. Like here. But I think that's what we want. Now, the only thing my cow pasture is missing is cows. So let's get some wheat. Oh, I do have some hay bales. I could probably do... I don't know if it's enough for that entire roof, but... I need some of this. It's a lot. We are going to have to breed some, I think. Let's actually leave this open. Now, there are lots of ways to get in, so I'll probably end up with horses inside of my cow pasture at some point. Would you like to come with me? I'll promise you I'll make you feel very loved, and your babies will feel loved right up to the end before I kill you. Yes, come, come, come. I do have another pit full of cows at my first base that we set up in this series. And that's where I get my... I have some leather. Yes, that's what you get from cows. See, was that guy in here or did he climb over? That was fast. Yeah, we're going to have lots of stuff other than cows in there probably, and I'm going to have to kill them. Let's get a few more. You, under the stuff that no one should be seeing. You don't see that. I swear, I fill in everything. Hey, come here. Okay, these guys are going to be a little bit difficult. Now, there is a trick to getting them to fall. Like, it resets every 30 seconds, I think. We're going to need to go to bed anyway. I wanted to thank everyone who's been watching lately. I've been getting, you know, more... views and view time and everything recently, and I'm not in it just for success or anything, but you know, it's rewarding to see things improve, and I hit 40 subscribers, which isn't a ton, but I'm certainly happy to reach that goal and hoping to keep climbing. Come here, make babies. Yes! Oh, give me that experience. Give me level 33. Are we missing you? You make love with you. Make the babies? Yeah, I'm not gonna collect any more. I think I'll wait for those guys to grow up and keep breeding these guys. And, I don't know, get a dozen cows out here. So mostly for aesthetic, like I said. Maybe if I'm really short on leather, I have been gathering leather for bookcases. There's our windmill. I have my render distance pretty low right now. I've been gathering bookcases for my preparation to be able to do interiors. I want to have like a bunch of bookcases and whatnot and be able to just go from house to house, plop them in, and do what I do. But anyways, this is about as good of a pasture that I think you're going to get, honestly. I am not a fan of, you know, the square. I'm not a fan of this little dip right here being only a little bit of... The contours of the land need to be a little different than they are. That's a lot better. Maybe even if we pull this in. It's the little stuff like this. Now... Do we want to fill this thing up with tall grass? I'm going to say, you know what would be a cool idea? If you guys have ever seen a cow pasture or horses, have you ever noticed that they'll have an area where there's lots of tall grass in the back? And then there'll be like an area here and all the grass is really short where they've been grazing. They seem to graze in one area and then move on to let the grass grow. I wonder if that's a thing or if I'm just talking out of my butt. So would it be interesting if we had a lot of tall grass in the back? Now we can't do this too neatly. And I want to get rid of the flowers. If we do it too neatly, it's going to be pretty obvious that it's not going to look organic. So if we do something like that, leave this area unplanted, and then come down here and add a spot there, and over here. Now let's get rid of these flowers and see what it looks like. Earlier I had mentioned starting a new city, a big city, like the Imperial City, or, you know, Central City, where all trade goes through and everything around here. Lots of houses, much bigger area than this. Big castle. And I was thinking, something that's always intimidated me is castle layout. If anyone knows of any good tutorials or something, I haven't looked yet either, so maybe all I need is a quick search. But I could really use a history lesson on castle layout and whatnot, because I've always been afraid that I'd start making a castle and I'd be like, this doesn't even make sense. It's just not very good. I want more bone meal for some too high grass, and I'm going to give that some time to grow in, that grass right there. Now, do we want some gravel in there or something? I'm going to say no. This is pretty fertile land, so I imagine that we got our cows on good grazing land. But yeah, that is something that I'm really looking forward to. I've never really built a castle, except if you look, I have some videos on a palace that I was making in collaboration with someone. Sorry, I gotta stop and crack my knuckles. They're like bothering me. And here we are getting an overhead look at it. Definitely needs more cows. Definitely does. That spot right there needs to grow in. I've got medium shaders on right now, so my frame rates are a little choppy. Everything's loading in. I've got my render distance really low. Let's get that back off. Anyways, that's going to be about it for this episode. If any of you were wondering how to make a cow pasture without making it look like a boring line of fence, which really that is what cow pastures look like. But that's not what we're doing. This looks much better. It's a good idea, I think. Try something like this in your world. Let me know how it works for you, or if you have any other designs or ideas to make this look a little bit better. We got quite a bit of work done here. Not just that, which adds a... This wasn't a big project. This was a small project that adds a lot of ambiance. And those are things I really love, as you know, from the secret tunnel back there and the wheat fields that you can't even see back there. It's the little things. We got this done. A lot of little stuff. I'm happy with what we got done here today. Anyways, where am I going? I just want a place to see what I'm wanting to see. Let's get a look where that dang cobblestone mass isn't in the way. We'll just say our farewells looking at this beauty. I do like this house. Anyways, guys, if you have any suggestions on what to build next, details to add to things that we've already done, let me know. I'll take them into consideration. Thanks for watching, everybody. Leave a like and subscribe if you enjoyed it. Bye. What da do, da da do, da da do.